The focus of this lesson is on multiplying conjugate complex factors together, and we're going to start off with a complex number 2 plus 3i. So in order to get the conjugate, it needs to have the same real part and the opposite imaginary part. So the real part is 2, so for our conjugate it will also be 2, and the imaginary part is 3, so for our conjugate it will be opposite sign, so it'll be negative 3. And then keep your I. So the conjugate of 2 plus 3i is 2 minus 3i. Now, if we want to list the corresponding factors for these two complex numbers, all we need to do is do x minus 2 plus 3i, and then also do x minus 2 minus 3i. And so often what I do is I kind of group that complex number to show that you are minusing that whole complex number. That's how we start off. And then that way, in my next step, I like to distribute that minus sign across the parentheses set. So it becomes x minus 2 minus 3i. And then for the next factor, it would become x minus 2 plus 3i, and the reason it becomes plus is a negative times a negative is a positive. And then what we do from there is, for good practice, since we're going to end up multiplying these factors together, we group the x term and the real part. And there's a reason we do that, and it actually helps in the multiplication. So then now I would go and I would multiply these two factors together, since that's our goal. And the way we're going to multiply is we're going to multiply using FOIL. So the first, outside, inside, last term of each of those factors will multiply together. So for first, it'll be x minus 2 times x minus 2, and I'm just going to list it initially, I'm not going to actually multiply yet. For the outside, it'll be positive 3i times x minus 2. For the inside, it's going to be negative 3i times x minus 2. And then for last, it's going to be negative 3i times positive 3i. And what I want you to notice on the outside and the inside pieces, they're basically identical except for the fact that for the outside piece it's positive and for the inside piece it's negative. So if you were to distribute the 3i for the outside piece and the negative 3i for the inside piece and then combine your like terms together, because they're just opposite in signs, they're going to actually add out to 0. So I'm going to just go ahead and cross them out to kind of simplify my work. I don't even have to deal with the outside and inside piece. And that will be the case for conjugate complex factors if you group them the way we did. And so all we have to worry about is the first and the last. So if I go to do the first piece, I kind of have to FOIL within this piece as well. So the first would be x squared. The outside would be minus 2x. The inside would also be minus 2x, and last would be positive 4. So that simplifies down to x squared minus 4x, when you combine like terms, plus 4. And then when we go to do the last piece, a negative 3i times a positive 3i would be negative 9i squared. And then we know that I squared is negative 1, so replace I squared with negative 1 as a factor. And so you get negative 9 times a negative 1, which is a positive 9. So taking your first and your last piece and adding them together by combining like terms, we are left with x squared minus 4x plus 13, which is considered an irreducible quadratic, because it's not able to be reduced over the real numbers.